Before we start today's episode, the Bum Squad crew wants to take a moment of silence to stand in solidarity with our brothers and sisters out there fighting in the Black Lives Matter movement and protesting for the equality across America. Now, music is a very important tool for healing in times like this. And with that being said, we're going to be showing you today some of our favorite songs from some of our favorite Black artists. I'm going to go ahead and kick things off with my Cruise Control. Today for Cruise Control, I got an artist that goes by the name of Lucky Day. That's Day with an E at the end of it. Now, Lucky Day is from New Orleans, Louisiana. The deluxe version of his album, Painted, just dropped recently within the last couple of weeks and got some serious bangers on there. Some notable tracks off of his new deluxe album, Painted, are Call, Floods, the Rolsimo Reggae remix, which is just ridiculous. Chronix did his thing on there. It's really good. But the song I'm bringing you today is off that very same album, and it's called Ready for Love. It gives me the vibe as if like Frank Ocean's little brother did the Robin Thicke experience. That's how I've been describing it. Once you hear the beat and the melodies, you'll definitely see what I'm saying. It has a lot of good violin and piano swells in it. You find this type of thing throughout the album, and it's very reminiscent of like the 90s and the early 2000s R&B wave that I'm a huge fan of. You can probably tell by now. This Lucky Day guy is definitely not going to just be here today, gone tomorrow. He's extremely talented. His production level is through the roof. Like, I'm just excited to see how he grows through this industry. Now, on the original version of this album, Ready for Love was an interlude, but I guess he knew as much as I did that it needed to be extended. So the deluxe has the extended version. We're going to go ahead and listen to it right now. This is Ready for Love by Lucky Day. Thinking you're ready for love. Yo, 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 what's good, what's good? Welcome back to Tunes. It's your boy, Kosi K.
It's your boy, Houdini.
And welcome back to the underground. Man, it's been a rough couple of weeks, but we still here and we still, you know, going forward and trying to stay positive and pushing through despite all the events going on, you know, COVID-19 and, you know, George Floyd and all of those matters. So really, you know, we just want to bring you guys some music to just, you know, lighten up the mood and just pretty much touch upon some, you know, some good vibes and
exactly
try to get back to that. But in lighter news, the artist that we have for today, the boy Wiz Kelly, man.
Boy Wiz Kelly, he's from Atlanta. You already know.
Phenomenal artist, man. He's a double threat.
Double threat producing, rapping,
all of that. I especially have, you know, a special place in my heart for, you know, these double threat artists, these producers and these rappers, because they make their own beats and they, you know, they cut corners in the sense of they do a lot of things by themselves. They do a lot of things, you know, it shows you that if you work hard enough, you can achieve that too. And Wiz Kelly, man, he's the perfect example for that, man. That boy going crazy. I know we say that a lot, but the boy going crazy. The song that we're doing today by the boy is
Crystal.
Let's just get straight to it, man. You know, the best part, the most fun part of the segment.
Look me in my eyes. Tell me what you see. Cause I know you've been running from me.
I know you've been running from me. From me.
Look me in my eyes. Tell me what you see. Cause I know you've been running from me.
I think I'm like an octave or something in like the,
You're an octagon.
I was like in chorus in like third grade, you feel me? So,
you were first chair?
Yeah, something like that. Octave, or what's the other thing called? It's octave, and then it's like I'm a falsetto, yeah.
You're
Flo, re, mi, fa, so, di,
you're a false claimer.
Nah, yeah, so you know, but yeah, the boy Wiz Kelly, once you listen to this song, he's kind of talking about some, like, it's kind of like some rebellious type of thing, you know what I mean? You get some real rebellious vibes going when you listen to this song, when you listen to this tune. Shout out to the boy Wiz Kelly. If you don't know him, go check him out, go listen to him. Double Threat, like I said, he's going stupid, makes wonderful music. Beats going crazy. Make sure you go buy his beats too. Make sure you go purchase his beats, because over here in Tunes, you know what I'm saying, we gonna do something eventually
purchase
where we
start
talking about like beats and stuff, because you know we like beats and all that cool stuff. Beats is real dope, you know what I mean? So shout out to all the people who make beats and the producers. Yeah, you know what I mean, it's not always just about the lyrics and stuff, you feel me? Sometimes it's about the beats. And I've and I feel like the people who make beats don't get enough credit sometimes, you know. So
no this, cap.
You know, one love to all my beat makers out there. one love to all my producers out there. You my smell me? Beater. Without further ado,
Crystal, Wiz Kelly. What's up, everybody? It's your boy Eric, aka Lil Guash, aka Dada Dawn, aka the Dawn Dada, aka your mama's best friend. Back at you with another episode, another segment, another whatever you want to call it, on a mystery box. Artist of the day, YTK. And the song I'm bringing for you guys, Prada. He just dropped a project this year called From Grace for Grace. I don't know who Grace is, but I really want to find out. I'm really intrigued. This is amazing music he's putting out. The man hails from the 410. Your boy, as you know, if you keep up with the tunes, if you don't, go back and watch the back catalog. Go back and watch all the old episodes. But your boy is from the 410. YTK, so it's not, it's fair to say he's pushing conscious rap. But he has fun with his shit. Like, I've been listening to his music for a very, like, a long time now. Like, a while, since, like, 2015, 2016, 2014. The song has a crazy, like, vibe switch, like, in the middle of it, right around the 1 minute mark. Like, it's kind of comparable. Not comparable, because I know my Frank Ocean fans are going to be out there just going crazy. In the song Nights by Frank Ocean, you know how it switches in the middle, blah, blah, yeah. Kind of like that here. There's a lot of, with the beat, there's a lot of like vocals like in the background of the beat. I don't know if they're ad-libs. I don't know if he like sampled a voice, but it's cool. If y'all don't already, make sure y'all go follow my boy YTK on Instagram at YTK. If I had to give an honest rating of the song, wow. Wait, hold on. I might actually just rate this song a solid 8. This is crazy. You know what? That's enough of today's episode of the Mystery Box. Let's just go ahead and spin that track. So go ahead and spin that track.
Keep that shit red, light it up the red.
What's good, my people? What's happening, my people? It's your favorite host of the farm. We've been gone for too long. Welcome to Foreign Flows. Before we even get into it, you know, election day was just, or not election day, but you know, it was a voting day in Georgia. I hope you people voted. You see, zoom in on this. I hope you people voted. Me, I voted. I don't know if you guys voted, but I hope you did. You know, Christian gave, you know, a beautiful moment of silence in the beginning, so I'm not gonna talk too much about what's going on besides. If you're not speaking up or doing something about it, then you're part of the problem. So I'm gonna just leave it at that, but let's get into it. So the artist we're gonna be talking about today, he's one of the most recognizable African artists, had one of the greatest decades in African music last decade. He goes by the name of Wizkid, y'all might've heard of him. So he hails from Nigeria. Yeah, I know I always do Nigeria, but he's from Nigeria, just deal with it. All right, so Wizkid's from Nigeria. We're not using the globe today, so you know what that means. Go ahead and slide that thing real quick by. Yes, sir. All right. Geography 101 with Mr. Maduka. So if we look at the map of Africa, you know what I'm saying? Nigeria is somewhere right here. You know what I mean? You know, we want to zoom in. Chris, do that thing you do with the camera right here. All right. Thank you, guys. Geography 101 with Mr. Maduka. That's about it. So yeah, WizKid is from Nigeria. Specifically, if you want to get into it, he's from the Yoruba tribe. The Yoruba tribe is one of the three major tribes in Nigeria. The song we're going to be talking about today is very old. It was released in 2014. It's called Oju Elegba. The reason I picked it for today's episode is because, you know, right now there's so much negativity going on, and this song is very uplifting. Oftentimes I call it like the second national anthem of Nigeria, because it's just so, when you hear it, it's like every Nigerian knows this song, you know. So Oju Elegba, the way to describe this song, it's a very powerful song, has a powerful message. The song is basically, in a nutshell, it's about his come up. Oju Elegba is a pretty rough part of Nigeria. I guess you could call it like the ghettos of Nigeria. And he just talks about, you know, his younger days and how he had to, you know, come up to where he is now, which is a great world-renowned artist. Man, that beat is gonna capture your attention off rip. Like, you're gonna hear it and you just start nodding your head. Like, it sounds so familiar but unfamiliar at the same time the first time you hear it, is the best way to describe it, honestly. As well, fun fact about this song, I would say, put a lot of people on the Afrobeats, because Drake and Skepta, UK artist, and obviously, I don't need to explain who Drake is, they hopped on the remix, and that really gave this song notoriety. But the original, I think personally, the original is the best version of the song. All right, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna jump into the best part of the segment. So with that being said, legendary beat, spin that track.
Subscribe to BSTV. Like, comment, subscribe. Cause we drop the hottest shit every week. And y'all know that shit. Stop playing with me.